Your journey has been comfortable so far and will be comfortable later on. That the source of comfort is your spirit. And the more you see to the comfort of your spirit, the problems of outside comforts drop out. You are not bothered as to where you live, where you sleep, what you eat, what you do. So to allow these gross sensitivities to drop down so that the inner subtler sensitivities go. That's why you are here, to get over your time, conditionings. I mean, it's a rat race, and the rat race has to be somehow or other stopped, once for all within and without. So here we can do it without, and once you start meditating, the within can be also achieved, and you can achieve that peace which we all human beings should have if we have to save this world from complete destruction. As you must have realized that now the Sahaja Yoga is growing much faster and it's taking a good speed, and we all have to keep ourselves equipped to be able to be part and parcel of this great evolutionary and revolutionary process which is going to stir up the whole world. For that it is important also to see that we take ourselves to task and don't get into mediocre living and mediocre thinking. We are people of very great potential. Not only that, but we are blessed by God's divine power. Try to use that power within yourself and try to be one with it. Little bit you have to see that you beat up your body, beat up your mind, beat up your ego and chisel it out so that it is beautifully made in such a way that you grow into that image for which you are made. Regarding other things like my tours in your countries, I think the greatest good is done to you when you come to this country, as if you belong to this country and you were uprooted in some other country. And when you come here, you prosper so well. And in that country I try so hard, I work so hard, do all kinds of things. All the time I spend with you, I do everything day in now, day in and night, all the time. I find it's impossible to achieve much that I see happening to you here, as if here you take absolutely with great ease the divinity of this place. And I think this uprootedness has to be given up. I think as if you have immigrated into those countries and now you are back in your own. You are not found out by immigration laws, I think. Now under these circumstances we should change our tactics and try to establish our ashrams here and our own projects here, so that you people should come down here and achieve more. You can earn your living there, but you should come here, spend some time for two months, 3 months continuously and establish yourself and grow, because I don't think it can be achieved there that good, because you tried everything. So this is the ultimate outcome of our trips all over. Despite all kinds of hazardous routes and hazardous life here, we are doing very well. I must say, when I see you, I find you are very good and you are all very much better and it's all improved. Like watches, you see, when you have to make them immune, you put them under absurd conditions and they get all right like that. Now you are immune. They are put into, I've seen, into troughs which are shaken very heavily, as you were shaken yesterday in the buses. And then they are made to pass through water which is running very fast on them. And all this we are trying here, and I think your immunity is growing very fast to outward things, and you are becoming really solid, eternal time pieces, the way you are created here. And I'm so very happy to see the development. That's the main point which we have achieved here. So the attention should be out away from money, first of all. That's one of the biggest problems. Actually, nobody can believe that affluent countries are much more money-minded than Indians are, though they are so developed. You see, the developed countries are much more money-minded than the Indians are. It's very surprising. When you see the way they count their pennies, it's impossible to believe that these are really developed people. They are worse than beggars sometimes. So that is what you should get out of it, the money part. Money is horrible stuff that people count. And I mean, it's better to count the names of God than to count the money, horrible coins. Then we have other things like gross attachments to comfort. I don't think it's a very comfortable life there. Because here you can move in the night anytime, you won't meet anybody who will snatch your purse or snatch your bangles. You can move about the way you like and nobody is going to bother you. You won't meet two, three drunkards beating each other, nothing of the kind. So it's a very pure life here. That's a very big achievement. And the comforts that you want, you can create later on if you want to have them. At least I personally think that too much modernization won't suit this place. So we should not give them these useless ideas which makes your body slaves to your own comforts and ideas of enslavement. In any case, cleanliness, personal cleanliness is very good here, but the general cleanliness has to be taught to these people. All this giving and taking process will work out very well, I'm sure. And the way things are moving within yourself, I have great hopes that you will really grow much faster if you come to this country and stay here for some time in a settled way and then go back to your countries. That would be much better than to have a visit to your countries, which I feel sometimes is just bombarded by negativity. The another point which I wanted to tell you is that you must learn to understand that you have come here to gain something. Nobody is going to gain anything out of you. So you have to gain something here. You are students and so you have to learn something and try to develop a sense of discipline like a disciple who receives all that is around. What's that? What's this? How is it? This is nice. That's nice. You see, like that. But if you go on seeing the things which are of no importance and loose talking about things that do not matter with you, all this has to be given up because you have so much time there that people sit down and jabber, talk, loose talks, ugly talks, useless talks. That's not needed at all. On the contrary, it's better to be quiet and assimilate more within yourself. Because here the people don't have time, so they can't talk, they have to work. But while you have time, they're also here. So we start like that, and that's a very wrong thing. Another talking is done with yourself also quite a lot. Like you start analyzing, criticizing, and finding faults and all the time thinking, oh, this could have been better, I've harmed very much here, or that has happened, all those things come into your heads. So this kind of a inner talk also should be stopped. You see, they are called as murmuring souls by Christ, who said, beware of murmuring souls. But these murmuring souls exist within us. So beware of them and don't listen to all nonsensical talks and try to keep a good eye on that and be alert, so it will help. On the whole, I must say, this trip and the last trip, I'm overjoyed and I'm very happy that it has brought forth so many possibilities before me and your potential. I'm very happy about it that somehow in this year we have achieved a new type of atmosphere among all of you, which is humble, which is quiet, which is peaceful, which is absorbing the divine, which is a very, very great joyous thing for me. So I thank you very much for all that. I hope you keep up your progress this way. आता आपल्या देशातील सहयोगांना सगळ्यांच्या तर्फे मी अत्यंत धन्यवाद देते की त्यांनी शांतपणाने सगळी कार्य केली, आपापसात भांडाभांडी केली नाही, एक दुसऱ्यांची नाचक्की केली नाही, राग दाखवला नाही आणि शहाणपणा धरून सगळी कार्य केली आणि त्यांच्या समोर एक चांगला नमुना ठेवला. त्यांना असं वाटतं की तुम्ही फार मोठी माणसं आहात, देवभक्त, शहाणी, फार व्यवस्थित संतुलित जीवन चालवणारी, अत्यंत चरित्रवान अशा. म्हणजे सगळ्यांना वाटतं तुम्ही सगळे शिवाजी महाराज आहात. थोडक्यात सांगायचं आणि अशा शिवाजी महाराजांना सगळ्यांना माझा नमस्कार. आता सांगायचं म्हणजे असं की कधी कधी खायचे दात दुसरे आणि दाखवायचे दुसरे असं असतं थोडं बहुत आपल्याकडे, कारण आपल्याकडे आदर्श इतके जास्त आहेत की मनुष्यामध्ये ढोंगीपणा येऊन जातो. वरून आपण दाखवण्यात फार चांगले होत आणि ते हे ओळखू शकत नाही, कारण हे म्हणजे सडेतोड लोक आहेत, यांच्यामध्ये आडपडदा नसतो. म्हणजे तो कधी कधी इतका होतो की त्याला आपण म्हणू ते बेशरम आहेत, पण त्यांच्यात जे आहे ते समोर मागे पुढे काही ठेवत नाही. पण आपल्यामध्ये ही कला फार अवगत आहे, तेव्हा आपण बाह्य दाखवायला फार चांगले बनतो आणि आतून आपल्यात बरीच खराबी असते, तेव्हा आपलं नुकसान याच्यात होणार आहे. आपण बोलायच्या वेळा अशा गोष्टी करू, एखाद्या माणसाला जर तुम्ही ऐकलं असेल वाटेल की साक्षात हे परमेश्वरच उतरले की काय पृथ्वीवर. पण जेव्हा त्यांच्या चारित्र्यात किंवा त्यांच्या आयुष्याकडे लक्ष दिलं तर असं वाटतं की ह्याच्यापेक्षा मोठा राक्षस कुणीच नाही. आणि असेच राक्षस आता परदेशात जाऊन ह्या लोकांना लुबाडून राहिले, कारण त्यांनी वरून वरून खूप गोड बोलायचं, चांगलं बोलायचं, आणखीन वागणं त्यांचं वरून दाखवायचं, म्हणजे केवढी सोजवळ आणि किती प्रेमळ. आणि तिथे जाऊन सगळ्यांचे पैसे काढले, सगळ्यांना उपाशी केलं, त्याची स्थिती खराब करून टाकली आणि परत तिथून त्यांना फार मानपान मिळाला. तर तशी आपल्यामध्ये थोडीशी ही चुणूक आहे, म्हणजे आपल्याला हे जमतं की बाह्यातलं एक दाखवायचं आणि आतलं एक. ह्या लोकांना जमतच नाही, म्हणजे करायचं म्हटलं तरी जमत नाही. तर ते विचारतात सुद्धा, पण तो म्हणतो की मी असा चांगला आहे, म्हणजे असं कसं. आमच्याकडे जर कोणी वाईट म्हणू शकतो स्पष्ट सांगेल की मी बा वाईट आहे, मी दुष्ट आहे. पण आम्ही म्हटलं असं सांगत नाही, आमच्याकडे सांगितलं तर मार खाणार, म्हणून लोक काही सांगत नाही. ते म्हटलं मी फारच चांगला आहे, अगदी महादुष्ट राक्षस असला तरी म्हणे मी फार चांगला उत्तम मनुष्य आहे, पण आतून आम्ही मात्र इतके कधी असू असं म्हणता येत नाही, म्हणजे एवढी जबाबदारी आपल्याला वाटत. तर सहयोगामध्ये काय, आत बाहेर दोन नाही, आत बाहेर आपण असा. आत बाहेर जो मनुष्य एक झाला, अंदर बाहेर एक ही जाणो, त्याला आत बाहेर नाही तो खरा संत साधू. जो आत बाहेर, मी तुम्हाला जर सांगितलं तुम्ही दारू प्यायची आणि मी स्वतः दारू पित बसले तर तुम्ही काय म्हणाल, एक साधी गोष्ट. पण जर मी हिंदुस्थानी असेल तर लपून छपून पिणार आणि सांगेन की बॉ तुम्ही दारू पिऊ नका आणि मी लपून छपून पिणार, हे आपलं हिंदुस्थानी पद्धत. इंग्लिश पद्धत काय की तुम्हाला सांगायचं तुम्ही दारू प्या म्हणजे परमेश्वराकडे जा, मी पितेन.